Majid Memon, the fact is there are uncles who are judges and there are nephews and nieces practicing in all courts. This has now become the Supreme Court versus the Allahabad High Court, but the malaise extends to the Supreme Court. It permeates through all the courts of the land, the district courts, the high courts. The fact is this is something that needs to be stopped, and that's something the collegium needs to be thinking about. How do we stop this practice? Either the judges are moved out, or for example, if somebody's been a lawyer in Allahabad High Court or some other high court, he shouldn't then be a justice in that court as well. Shouldn't some sort of mechanism be brought in place that this uncle judge syndrome ends, and ends now? Because as Prashant Bhushan says, it is undermining the public's belief in our judicial system.
No, see Rahul, if you can give me a little time, I will explain what you are asking. See, first let us understand, it is not head-on collision between Supreme Court and Allahabad High Court alone. As rightly said, this is the menace all over the country. Various high courts in the country, there are judges from the High Court and the Supreme Court. We are not talking of district level or magistrate level, because then it becomes too wide a subject to discuss. Now, I must tell you that honestly speaking, a very fair and unbiased assessment would lead us to the conclusion that even today, in spite of widespread corruption all around in Indian society, our judges, who are honest and with impeccable integrity, they certainly outnumber these black sheep. There's no doubt on that at all. But then there are a few black sheep which pollute the entire atmosphere in the Indian society with regard to the fair name of administration of justice, which needs to be cured. Now, when you talk of uncle judge, see, If you recall, Mr. Bhushan or Mr. Sodhi will agree with me, sometime in the 80s and 90s, it was suggested that lawyers who become judges or members from the bar or from lower judiciary, if they are to be elevated to the High Court, they would be posted outside their states. That device was with a view to prevent, wielding power within your circle. Therefore, a Bombay lawyer would be posted in Gujarat, a Gujarat lawyer would be posted in Allahabad, something of that kind. But it did not work. And now today, if you look at this from this point of view, even if you impose this condition that close relatives, which would include spouse, children, brother, etc., etc., would not be permitted to practice in a judge's court. This is hardly any cure to prevent corruption, because the two judges who are brother judges, who are not in fact related, can exchange their relatives, and then the corruption merely can go on, which is what is happening all over the country. That's not the remedial measure. That is not the... See, you can't cure this menace by imposing any kind of restriction that relatives would not step into the judge's court. This is hardly any cure. Corruption is to be dealt with with a very firm hand. At the disciplinary action against the judges. Now tell me, from 1950, when the constitution came into force, how many judges have been impeached in our history?